Hi everyone, welcome to Irfan CFPS YouTube channel. In our last class, we have discussed system operation of non-interlock preaction system by using schematic diagrams. In today's class, we shall go through double interlock type preaction system in detail, considering electric pneumatic release using schematic diagram for our easy understanding. If this is the first time you are watching our channel, make sure to hit the subscription button below and click the notification icon to get the updates on our courses related to firefighting systems. Dear students, before we move ahead with the double interlock preaction systems, let us have a recap on what exactly preaction system is all about. Just to remind you, in preaction systems, water is filled till the preaction deluge valve. As you can see on your screen, a supplemental detection system is installed in the same area as the sprinklers. All the sprinklers are normally closed and normally there is no water in the piping. When fire occurs, a supplemental detection system senses the fire and automatically opens the preaction valve. When the preaction valve opens, water will flow into the piping system. Water discharge occurs from each individual sprinklers as they fuse in response to heat. Now let us go through double interlock preaction systems. In double interlock preaction systems, as you can see on your screen, preaction valve will only activate upon operation of both the detection devices and these closed sprinklers. It means these two events must occur before water enters into the system piping. Activation of the detection system alone or operation of sprinkler system alone will sound an alarm but will not cause the system to fill with water. In this double interlock system, system piping is pressurized with air or nitrogen using a dedicated riser mounted compressor or tank mounted compressors. These systems are used in freezer storage warehouse conditions, which commonly referred as refrigerated area systems, where the consequences of water getting into the piping are severe. They are also commonly used where flooding of the pipe can have serious consequences and where it is important to control accidental water discharge due to damaged sprinkler piping. In this slide, let us go through the main components of double interlock preaction systems. As you can see on your screen, there are various main components like releasing control panel, detector, deluge valve with this complete trim assembly configuration. We have E2 solenoid valve and E1 pneumatic actuator with electric pneumatic trim E3. Apart from that, we have the piping connected to the sprinklers and also pressure operated relief valve. Apart from these components, we have alarm bells, compressors and also pressure switches and strainers, orifice. All these are required for proper functioning of the system. These systems utilizes a deluge valve controlled by a pneumatic actuator E1, normally held closed by supervisory pressure maintained in the automatic sprinkler system, and a normally closed electric solenoid valve E2 controlled by an approved system control panel with compatible detection system. Both the electric detection system must activate and supervisory pressure must be relieved from the sprinkler system before the preaction deluge valve will open to fill the sprinkler system with water. Now let us go through the system operation of double interlock electric pneumatic release preaction system. As you can see on your screen, main components again. In set conditions, the system water supply pressure enters into the priming chamber of the deluge valve through 1/4 inch or 8 mm priming line, which includes a normally open priming valve B1, strainer B2, restricted orifice B3, and a check valve. As you can see, this line is connected on the deluge valve priming chamber. In the set condition, water supply pressure is trapped in the priming chamber by check valve B4 and both electric actuator, which is normally closed E2, and normally closed pneumatic actuator. The water supply pressure trapped in the priming chamber holds the deluge valve clapper closed, keeping the outlet chamber and the system piping dry. In fire condition, when the detector or the detection system operates, system control panel energizes the solenoid valve E2 to open. Alarms will activate, but the deluge valve A1 will not open until a sprinkler opens, relieving supervisory pressure from the sprinkler system. Since this system piping line is connected through an air compressor, as you can see on your screen, from the air compressor the line is connected to the system piping above the check valve. You have an air pressure in order to measure the air in the system piping. When a sprinkler opens, supervisory pressure in the sprinkler piping is reduced, causing the pneumatic actuator to open, since the air compressor line is also connected to the pneumatic actuator. After both the electric detection system activates and supervisory pressure in the sprinkler system have been lost, pressure is released from the priming chamber to the open drain cup B14 faster than it is supplied through the restricted orifice to the priming chamber. The deluge valve clappers opens to allow water to flow into the system piping, and alarm devices which are connected will be operated, and the pressure switches which are connected to the alarm bells also activates. An optional accelerator may be installed to accelerate the pressure loss from the sprinkler system to provide earlier alarms and or to allow the system to fill with water faster. An accelerator may be necessary to meet the system discharge requirements. When the deluge valve A1 operates, then the sensing end of the PORV B10 is pressurized, causing the PORV to operate, and the water will flow through the PORV to the drain. When the PORV operates, it continually vents the priming chamber to prevent the deluge valve from resetting even if the open releasing devices close. Please note that the deluge valve A1 can only be reset after the system has been taken out of service and the outlet chamber of the deluge valve and associated trim piping are depressurized and drained. As we discussed that both the detection system and sprinkler system must be activated in order to open the preaction valve and in order to flow the water into the system piping. In case if any of these systems will activate, then the deluge valve will not be opened, only the alarms will be activated. In case if you want to open the deluge valve manually, then we have an emergency release B11, which can be pulled. Then the pressure is released from the priming chamber. As you can see, this line, priming line, is connected to the manual release. The pressure will be released through the priming line and it will flow to the drain point. Once the pressure is released from the priming line, the deluge valve will open. Water will flow into the system piping and the alarm devices. If a sprinkler head opens, then only water will flow from the system. I hope you enjoyed our class. In next class, we shall learn about deluge systems. Thanks, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to learn more on fire protection systems. Make sure to hit the subscription button below and click on the notification to get the updates. Thank you once again. Bye.